what's up? Welcome back to London. In this video, I'm going to be breaking down how expensive things are here. As you can see, I'm just in the underground at the moment. Actually, this is an overground station. 55% of the London Underground is actually overground. I'm going to start with my hostel. So I stayed in a place called Astor Kensington, which is near Bayswater Underground Station. That cost me just £13 a night. And as you can see from these pictures, it's actually quite comfortable. £13 a night for London is actually very good in terms of hostels. If you want an even better one, you can expect to pay £20 to £25, possibly even more if you're looking at a hotel. But if you're on a budget like myself, you're gonna find Astor Kensington to be just about right in terms of comfort and price. For breakfast, I just went to a famous chain which originally started here in London, but it's all over the UK, called Pret. And I just had a hummus and salad wrap with a banana and also some still water. That came to £5.99. And here I'm gonna show you the prices of some of the other things in Pret you can get. You can see here the prices of the sandwiches. £4 for flatbread, £3 for the wraps, £3.15, and the baguettes, £3.25, £4.50, £3.50. Pots of fruit, £3, £2.35. Yogurt, chia pots, drinks, big still water, £1.50, juice, over £2, smoothie, £3.69. A little pricey compared to other countries, but for the UK, that's actually quite normal. As you can see, I've got my raincoat on today because it is chucking it down. I'm not sure if you can tell. See if I can focus the screen. Anyway, yeah, so I'm gonna have to do a lot of filming inside today as it's supposed to rain all the way up until 4 p.m. and then calm down a little bit. I'm now in an area called South Kensington, very nice part of London. Kensington's actually one of the most expensive areas in the whole of London, but that's not the reason I'm here. I'm here to show you a few of the museums which you can enter all for free, all in this area. There are a few to choose from. So I'm now outside the Natural History Museum, which is free to enter here in South Kensington. And it's only a Thursday, but check out the queue. On any rainy day, all of the museums are gonna be packed because everyone's going there. And so I'm not gonna go inside, I'm gonna move on to some of the other museums in this area, which are also free to enter. So I'm now here at the much more peaceful Victoria and Albert Museum. Actually finding somewhere this therapeutic and this grand is quite hard to do because everywhere that's good is usually really densely populated with people. There's so many free things to do in London, and I just wrote a few down on my phone here. Tate Modern, the Science Museum, the Natural History Museum, the British Museum, the Imperial War Museum, the Victoria and Albert Museum. Then you have all the parks, Hyde Park, Greenwich Park, Regent's Park, St. James's Park, Green Park, Kensington Gardens, and on top of that, you can also just roam around like in the video I did yesterday. So there's still so much you can do here without having to fork out a lot. You can walk down Oxford Street. I guess the same goes for everywhere around the world, but particularly somewhere as expensive as London, it can really make a difference to your trip. So it's a bit later on now, and as you can see, it stopped raining. I went to a traditional British pub for lunch called The Bunch of Grapes here in High Kensington, South Kensington, I should say. And for £10.49, I got a Thai red curry, which, to be honest, tasted very good, but the portion they gave me was really not enough, considering the price. Anyway, here's a look at a few things on the menu.
Sandwiches, £6-7. £3 for fries, burger, 10, 11, 12 pounds, steak, up to 15 pounds, classic pub food, around 10 pounds and over, and also desserts, all for 5 pounds.
So right now I'm heading towards the London Underground to show you what it's like. It's a very famous part of London that I didn't cover in my previous video. And we'll add up the costs for my trip so you get an idea of how much transportation is too for the Underground. So you can either buy a ticket from here or you can use your own debit card to get through. You can also get something called an Oyster card, which you can top up. But usually, if you use a contactless card, it will just charge you for one journey each time. So if you're not taking the Underground a lot, then maybe that's a better idea. But if you're taking the Underground using an Oyster card many times, then maybe an Oyster card is going to be the better option for you. Anyway, train is now here. So having took the Underground, I'm now here in High Street, Kensington, and I'll be walking towards Hyde Park, which is only 5 or 10 minutes or so from here. And it's huge, Hyde Park, absolutely massive. Winter Wonderland is held there every year in December. It's an amazing event. If you ever come during Christmas time, I recommend that you can go to. Anyway, onwards. So I'm now inside the Kensington Gardens area of Hyde Park. As you can see, very peaceful, lovely for a stroll because it's been a rainy day, of course, not that many people here now, which is good because I don't like crowds too much. Kensington Palace is just around the corner. If you want to go inside Kensington Palace, you have to pay for a ticket, although you can just go up to the entrance for free, like I just did. And you can also stroll around Hyde Park and all the other green spaces in London for free. I'm now gonna go into a supermarket to show you the typical cost of things. I might go in one or two different ones to give more of a balanced view, because some are more expensive than others, of course. Start with a Tesco. 60p for water or drinks, roughly around £1.30, £1.25. Sandwiches, £2.20, £2.20, £2.50. 69p for a packet of tomatoes, £2 for a pot of fruit, mango, strawberries, £2, 25p each for a banana, 45p each for an apple. Just £1 for a loaf of bread. Again, £1, white and brown. £1.10, £2.30 for nuts. That's very niche. If you're wondering about the cost of alcohol, for a 4-pack of Budweiser, £4.30. Some Desperados, 3 bottles is £4.85, and Corona, £5.50. Bottles of wine, you can see the prices here. These ones are cheaper. You have rosé and some white wine. So that Tesco was tiny. Usually they're a lot bigger, there's a lot more choice, but it is one of the cheapest supermarkets in the UK. Cheapest possible is Aldi or Lidl, but I haven't seen them in London too often. They're usually in more local places from my experience. We're gonna go into Sainsbury's local now, and we'll compare the prices, which is generally Sainsbury's is a little bit more expensive than Tesco.
Starting with the fruit, it's 25p each for a banana, 40p for a single lemon, pack of apples, four will cost you £1.45, pack of grapes £2.20, 55p for a cucumber, 60p for some broccoli, £1 for a pack of cupped mushrooms, £1.25 for a lot of carrots, dairy milk chocolate, £1.50, £1.10 for Hovis bread, £1.05 for Kingsmill, Warburton's white, 95p, dairy milk chocolate, £1.50, regular size Kit Kat, just 50p, £1.10 for Hovis bread, £1.05 for Kingsmill, Warburton's white, 95p, 85p for a regular size semi-skim milk, for dairy-free milk, £1.55 Alpro. Sandwiches in Sainsbury's are £2.25 on average. The ones at the top are £2. Drinks, £1.45 for orange juice, a bottle of Highland Spring, this size, only 95p. Four packs of alcohol again is a similar price to Tesco, ranging around £5. Strongbow dark fruit cider, £5.25 for four.
Hope that roughly gave you an idea about how much things are in general. That's not really just for London. I would say prices in both of those supermarkets is the same everywhere else in the UK. You're gonna pay a little bit more if you go in a more expensive supermarket, if it's like Waitrose or Marks and Spencer, but you can also pay much less if you go to Aldi or Lidl. Right, so I just jumped on the underground and I've come to King's Cross Station. About to take my train home back to Huntingdon, which is near Cambridge where I live. But before that, I'm just having my dinner here in London and accounting this for my cost for today to finish things off. So I've got a sorted vegetable burrito, also some still water. That comes to £7.95, and you can see here I also recorded the price board from inside. Another place up here called Giraffe. You can see the menu just now. I didn't decide to eat there because if you got a falafel burger or something else, usually you need to add fries, and that's already quite a bit more than if I eat here. Hey, what's up? It's now the following day and I'm back in my home in Huntingdon, and the costs of those underground journeys that I was waiting to come through into my bank statement has come through, and it's come to £9.80 for my day's underground trips using my contactless debit card. You can also use an Oyster card, I just found contactless easier. £9.80 using zones 1 to 4 is the daily cap. You're not gonna actually spend more than that. They'll only charge you the limit once you reach it. And I reached it yesterday because I took a few journeys. So after that, I can now add everything together. £13 a night for my hostel, £5.99 for my breakfast in Pret, bunch of grapes, red Thai curry for lunch, £10.49, and the London Underground costs £9.80, and of course my dinner, the burrito I had, including the water, £7.95. Adding all of that together, my daily total is £47.23. Definitely the most expensive how expensive is video I've ever made. I'm not really surprised as it is London. That's a lot of money considering I haven't even paid for any attractions on this day. I didn't go in the Tower of London. I didn't pay for a tour of anywhere. I just went to free stuff and I still spent basically 50 quid, and that's staying in a cheap hostel. Staying in a nice place and actually doing activities, buying things, and actually eating in more expensive places, your daily total could reach a high number. London is expensive as traveling goes. I'm sure you already knew that before you watched this video, but maybe you can do it slightly cheaper than you thought because of this video, and I hope it's useful and gives you a good reference for London. Thank you for watching, and I'm leaving for my next country in just a couple of days' time. That vlog is probably gonna come out quite quickly after this one, so stay tuned to find out what country I'll be going to next, and I'll see you then. Peace.